Hey friends, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. In today's video, we are going to be doing a massive whole house declutter as well as a clean out. You guys know if you've been here for a while, I am getting ready to move, so it is time to completely declutter this house. In today's video, I will show you room by room that I'm going to take care of today and just get rid of whatever we don't need. If you're new here, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I provide weekly cleaning motivations on Monday to get you ready for your week, get you motivated to do whatever you have on your to-do list and get things done. So I'm starting off this video with doing the dreaded socks. You guys, laundry, it's nonstop. And socks are constant. So I am doing those right now. I took about 3 days to do this video just because if you are new here, I am about 16 weeks pregnant. I will be on Wednesday and my energy has been lacking. So a little bit every day gets the job done. It is getting it done. It's not perfection, but I'm making some progress for sure. So I am going to go through the toys. I have actually been selling things like crazy in my house, and I sold the 12 cube little system that we had with all their toys and the bins. So we are going to declutter the toys first. As you could have seen, or as you may have seen, it was like a little bit daylight when I was doing the socks, and now it is dark, but that is just the way it goes. I do not get like unlimited time to clean and do things because being a mom and having things to do, that is very hard to do. So you will see different outfit changes. You will see it being day and night because that is real life, you guys. As we declutter all of these toys, they are being very selective. I always like to have my kids involved in this process. When they're younger, it's not the greatest idea because they want everything. But now that they're older, I have taught them that if you have too much stuff, you can't value what you have. And so they are learning to be more and more selective. We got rid of so many toys. You will see eventually in the video, this entire box that I have here is full of things that we get rid of. I have had you guys ask me, how do you get your kids to help clean up or declutter or whatever the case might be? My biggest suggestion and advice would be make it a game. Like I told Josiah, go through all of the cards. I'm going to put the camera on you. I'm going to time you and do this really quick. And it was a game to him and it was exciting. And he felt so good about himself when he was all done. It is day two, and if you can see, if you've been here, you remember this room was our office. The kids kind of took it over. I sold all of the bookshelves, the desk, which was actually a table, and Chris made a custom top, and the chair. I sold it all because when we are getting rid of stuff, I am not messing around. I get in gear really quick. So I got rid of that stuff, and I'm excited because I'm going to take that money that we make from selling the items and buy new stuff for the new house. So that's awesome, and I don't want to take it to the storage unit because I don't want to pay to store something that we're going to get rid of. You know what I mean? So we are actually going to clean out this area right here. I got a little sentimental and was going through some of the baby books, but I got focused. He's going through all of his books. He has a ton of books. I love to read, but I'm more of like an audible type of girl. So I'm not I'm not sentimental when it comes to books, but he is. So he had to go through that, and I'm going through some of my stuff that was in my little cabinet I had in the office. I'm going to tidy up the kitchen really quick. It is an absolute mess. My house was trashed. I don't know about you guys, but whenever I declutter, everything comes out, and my house is absolutely trashed. You guys, there was stuff everywhere. No kidding. We had a birthday party to go to this morning. So now that it's in the afternoon, I'm going to clean this kitchen. I'm going to clean off these counters and get things kind of back to where they need to be. I cannot declutter unless the house is semi-clean because I cannot pull everything out of drawers when there's junk everywhere. Look at this island. It's a disaster. I'm going to finish up what I was doing the night before. That was Friday. This is Saturday. And I'm going to clean off this table even more because I am going to start packing up some of our items that need to go to the storage unit. I am only going to be taking things that I really love to the new house. So this is one thing that I love and I will be keeping for a very long time. I got it from Home Goods for about $12, and I think it's just beautiful. Some friends of ours gave us a ton of boxes and some bubble wrap, so I am going to utilize it. I usually don't take this much care when packing my items. I can honestly say that, but this time I'm trying to do it right. I'm a mess, just trying to guess my way through this.
me.
I am going to have to find a special box for all of the pictures and the frames because they're a little bit larger. So I'm going to go ahead and put all of this stuff on the kitchen table and start wrapping it up with bubble wrap. There is a picture of me and Isabella. She was about 6 months old. I was 20 years old. And I love that picture so, so much. We were living in low-income housing. And I was filled with so much joy. I did not let it steal my joy. I just embraced the season we were in. I was so thankful we were in our own place. I didn't care if it was only $200 a month. And it was practically like, I don't want to say the ghetto, but it was a hard area, a hard part of town. But looking back, I see so many good memories that started in that house just because she was so sweet and I was kind of coming into my own, a young mother doing it on my own, and I felt so proud of myself. So a little encouragement for you guys. If you're not where you want to be, it is okay. God's got you there for a reason, and the season will change. Seasons always change. And so embrace where you're at, learn the lesson that you're supposed to learn, and you will be able to grow and thrive, and your dreams will come true. Just keep praying, keep pushing through, because listen, everybody has a beginning and everyone has an end. But don't be so focused on that end. Enjoy the journey, because it is what makes you who you are. So I'm going to be actually giving this table to my sister-in-law. Chris built this for me when we moved into this house, right before we moved to this house, and I love it, but he does not want it to go with us, so I'm going to get something else, and it's beautiful. It's sturdy. He doesn't like the color anymore, and he doesn't want to go through the process of staining it, like sanding it and staining it, so we are going to give it to my sister-in-law. He is actually cleaning. We are all chipping in. That is what we have to do with such a large family. He's taking care of the kitchen and I'm going to go into the living room. I have the kids right now actually working in their bedrooms. You guys asked, like I said earlier, how do you get your kids involved? We make it a family affair, make it fun, make it a game, and it is a family affair. We are all working. No one's sitting back and relaxing. If you've been here, you may see times where I'm the only one cleaning. Well, that's because I need the content and I'm going to be cleaning. But generally, everybody has to clean. Everybody has to move. You don't get the opportunity to sit on your butt and watch mom clean. So I know on YouTube, you guys might think, oh, does she ever have her kids clean? Well, yes, you have to remember, you are only getting a small glimpse of my life. And my house gets messy every day. So everybody has to pay their part. Whew, words are hard. You saw that mess all over the floor. That was Hazel's doing. She is the messiest puppy. Actually, she's not even a puppy anymore, but I don't mind it because she's so stinking cute. You are going to see some real life shenanigans. You know when you tell your kids to go to bed and then suddenly they want to play with each other nicely? Yeah, you're going to get a glimpse of that in just a second. Okay, you guys, it is like the third day that I'm gonna try to finish this video. It has not been easy. We've had birthday parties and stuff that we've had to do, so I've done little pieces. But this is the third day, the final day. I'm gonna get everything done. I'm gonna pack up some more. I think I'm gonna take care of one of the bathrooms, and we are gonna finish this video. So thank you for still being here with me. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you haven't yet already, and let's get started. It is day three, and I'm gonna start with this pile of laundry. I will be very honest. I put my foot down and I said, I am tired of the laundry. Somebody else is gonna have to do it because I was having a hard time bending over and I was just so sick, and the smell of the clothes, clean or dirty, was making me want to throw up. So I actually had to change my fabric softener and the laundry detergent several times because I could not stand the smell. So Chris has really stepped in. Drew does his own laundry. He's 15. Chris has stepped in so much, but this pile always gets bigger and bigger because the kids take a bath in here, and it's a mess. So I'm gonna take care of that, put it out in the room. He's gonna do the laundry while I start decluttering all of my items in the bathroom.
someone.
When we move, and I will mention this, I'm going to put all of this in a container, but I'm not going to be taking any of these little plastic containers with me because they are stained, as you can see, but I'm not quite ready to go to the rental. That's going to be about another 2 weeks, I think. We close on the 30th, so probably the weekend before we'll start moving things over there, and then I will probably just donate all of this stuff, but I got rid of so much, you guys. I was so proud of myself. Race like a shotgun. You gotta be my someone. Also, another little tidbit, I love makeup. I don't wear that much makeup, but I love makeup. My mom worked at Maybelline when I was very little. She was a chemist and she would always bring samples and I was obsessed. And then I actually worked at Ulta as one of my jobs as a single mom. I worked a full-time job and I worked 3 part-time jobs and Ulta was one of them. So I love, love, love makeup. I am going to also tackle the behind the mirror here. Again, most of this stuff I'm not going to really put away until it's time for us to go because I'm still using all of it. But it's good to kind of take inventory of what I have because I have way, way, way too much. So I have had you guys ask me, where do you get started? You feel overwhelmed with getting started. And I honestly think tidy up your area like I had mentioned and then start with one room. For one thing, like do a hall closet or under a bathroom sink and declutter like crazy. If you haven't used it in 6 months and you don't need it or you don't really love the item, even though you spent your money on it, get rid of it or give it to someone else if that makes you feel better. But do not allow it to continue to stay in your home. So yeah, just get rid of whatever you don't need and whatever you do love and you don't use it all the time, use one of these containers. Always go to Walmart or Target to get these Sterilite containers because they're 97 cents opposed to $1 at the dollar store and the lids don't work as well. And put your overflow items like you saw that I had there, Q-tips, cotton pads, whatnot, and then just only keep what you really love. And if you accidentally get rid of something and you're like, oh man, I really need it, then go ahead and buy it again. It's not a waste because now you know you'll really use it. And just limit what you buy. Always take inventory of the things you have. That's why staying on top of cleaning and staying on top of decluttering is so important because you have a mental inventory of your mind of what you have and you won't over purchase things. So the items I'm going to continue to use until we actually move, I'm going to put back in my little linen closet here. It is very tight and I'm going to put that in there and so it is easily accessible. And then when it's time to go, I'll just put it in a box and take it to the rental house. It feels so good. The room, even though it's probably not like really bigger, but when you declutter, it feels bigger. And I'm telling you, like decluttering and organizing, oh my gosh, it's my love language. I'm such a nerd. I love like meticulously going through things and making it all organized. And I cannot wait in the new house to just go crazy with all the organization. Color-coded, acrylic bins, labels galore. Y'all, I am so ready. Okay, so I, as you saw, took care of all of this. It might not look like I did a lot, but I really did. I'm gonna flip you guys around real quick. Okay, obviously, you saw I cleaned out, let me move this. This is more trash. I cleaned out this area. I won't be taking all this makeup with me to the new house, but actually, let me take that back. I will be taking all this makeup to the new house, but I wanna put them in like plastic containers. I won't be wearing it all, but I don't want this to go into a storage unit. So just because, you know, heat and everything, we are going to get an air conditioned unit, but still I want to have it like, you know, right there. I just want it air conditioned. I just want it somewhere near me. There we go. Making that clear. Okay. So sorry, I'm so out of breath. I cleaned out under here. That little white bin I had since Isabella, I was pregnant with Bella. I don't know why it's moved with me so much. Those are just like the extra like cotton ball or cotton rounds, floss and things like that. Things that we'll need. I'm gonna put my makeup in one of these bins when it's time for us to move. And obviously I went through here. I'm gonna put one of these in a bin as well. Here are things I'm gonna be packing. Like curling irons and things I don't need, a Scentsy warmer, my Kenzie, and anything like that I can pack up and I'm okay with being in a storage unit. Over here, these are the things I'm gonna be taking to the rental with us. I am gonna go through this as well. This won't be coming, well actually it may come with us. Or I actually could use it, you know, I could use this for my makeup and I might do that, but this is where I have like all of them. Like medical stuff that I keep here. I'll be cleaning this one out a ton when I'm so out of breath. I'm sorry, you guys. When we get closer to actually starting to take things over to the new house, I'm gonna clean that out. I'm gonna put my makeup in there. There's no point in buying more bins. I'll just put my makeup in there and it'll be fine. And then I'm gonna take those with us and take the toilet paper with us because I am gonna bring my own sheets and my own towels. This bin here is of all of the hair supply stuff. This is all my nail stuff. I'll take it with me. That's like, I'll probably get rid of a lot of it. Some of it's like dip powder. This is the lamp. And this is honestly just all my old Invisalign and the Smile Direct Club. I always keep my impressions just in case I need to go back and use them, which I actually do today. This is so gross, but I have been looking everywhere for this retainer. I haven't worn my retainer in months. My teeth are starting to shift. So I actually found it, so I've got it in here because I'm going to be cleaning those and sterilizing those. Overall, it's pretty good. We've made some headway. I personally won't do Chris's side. That's for him to do because he'll need to go through it. He said he's gonna get rid of a ton of stuff, but there is like lots of stuff under here for him to do. And I'll give him a box and he can do that. I think it's important for people to go through their own things. That way we don't, I don't throw away anything that they really like. So I'm gonna continue working a little bit every day. I'm really excited to share something with you guys. I have been feeling very like, I'm a very creative person. If you guys have been with me for a while or follow me on Instagram, you know that I had a boutique. I've always been someone who's got my hands in something. And so I did, I'm gonna set you down for just a second, you guys, sorry. Okay, so I know this is a weird angle, but my neck is really sweaty, honestly. But, sorry. So I've always had my hands in something, and so I used to have a boutique. It was called Tooley Tube at first. It's what my mama used to call me when I was little, a little Tooley Tube. And then I changed it to Purposeful Joy, which if you've been here with me since the beginning, that's what this channel started out as. Leave me a heart emoji if you guys have been here since Purposeful Joy. But so I've always had a little boutique. I've always had my hands on something. I've always been trying to make money on the side. Just, I'm very creative, I feel like. And so I've always been the type of person, if I see something, I'm like, I can do it. Even at 3 years old, this is a common story in my family. I was 3 years old, I'm like, oh, I can drive that car. And by the time I was four, I got in the little driver's seat and tried to drive that car, which all I did was, my papa had left his truck on and I had climbed over and I pulled it. It was like an Isuzu, a 1980 something Isuzu truck, and I just pulled it. You know how you like, well, steering wheel, you pull it like that. I just pulled it into gear and it made it roll back. And I was like, I can't touch the pedals. But same thing when I was little, I was like, oh, I can swim. And I swore I could swim in my head. I'm like, I can swim. And I jumped into the pool and I sank. And I remember looking at the bottom, or excuse me, from the bottom looking at the top thinking, I can't swim. I can't swim. Praise God, my stepfather's brother was there and he came and saved me. But that's just been my personality. I've always seen something and been like, oh, I can do that, no worries. And so YouTube has been one of those things. And I, in my mind, I always envisioned being able to like do DIYs and things like that with YouTube. And as I started getting more and more into it and taking it more and more seriously, I started to feel like I couldn't really do what I wanted on this channel. And then I felt like, ugh, I'm gonna have to niche down so hard, I'm just gonna do cleaning. Which, do not get me wrong, you guys know I love cleaning. You've heard of the crazy stories of me cleaning at 8 years old till 2 a.m. with a toothbrush. But I love to clean, there's no doubt about it. I love to clean, I love to organize. Organizing is my love language. That's a part of who I am. But not only that, a part of who I am is to motivate and to inspire and to show you all the other things that I like to do. Like, I like to make handmade farmhouse signs. I like to make wreaths. I like to, you know, show you guys how to meal prep. And after talking with my friend, I was like, you know, I'm just really feeling like my creativity is being like squashed a little bit. I want to produce more videos for you guys, but I'm so scared YouTube is going to almost penalize me for not doing just cleaning. And she gave me a lot of clarity. I encourage you guys to find a friend that just will like jerk you up when you need it. And she was like, listen, this is what I did. I did what I wanted to do, and then I did what was good for your channel. And it really gave me like a sense of like, okay, I'm gonna try it. So, you know, I have the other channel and that was honestly supposed to be Chris's channel. And he's just so busy trying to take over the business and
He's got a second job at the church, so it's been hard for him. He's going to start taking over that channel more. But on my channel, I'm really excited because I'm going to start implementing the things that you guys have asked for. More routines. You've asked for meal prep. Whenever I do DIYs and crafts, you're like, oh, I love it. Please keep adding that stuff. So you're going to get cleaning, organizing, motivation every single week like you already do. That is not going to change. But I'm going to be adding a second video of meal preps and routines, and maybe we'll do like a, you know, obviously I do decorating on here, but maybe we'll do a decorate with a shop with me. I don't know. But I'm starting to feel excited and excited to share more of you guys with me, or share me more of me with you guys. And that makes me excited. That makes me so excited. I love the other channel because over there I can be free and do what I want. But the reality is I don't feel like I am a vlogger. I don't feel that in my bones. I love to take you guys along with me here and there, but to produce a vlog every single week has been hard for me because I don't think I have the most exciting life. I mean, I'm just like a normal person, and I'm like, I run into constantly like, they do not want to see what I'm doing every day. And maybe you do, and I've heard you guys say like, yes, we just want to spend the day with you. I love that, but for me, it's like, I don't feel like that's exciting, and so it's hard for me to get excited for the video. So, Chris is gonna take over more of that channel. That is still gonna stay exactly the same. That's not changing. It's still gonna be nothing but our family. But over here, I am so excited to get more structured videos of more cleaning, more decorating, more organizing, more meal preps, more like, hey girl, this is what I'm up to right now. I've been dying to do that. That is what I've always wanted this channel to do. And so I'm going to be testing that out and see how it does. Let me know in the comments below. So many of you are like I'll say like, what is the best day? And you guys are like, whenever you post. But honestly, do you love to sit down on a Sunday and watch a YouTube video? Do you find yourself leaning more on Mondays? When do you find yourself looking for routine videos, cleaning videos, meal videos, crock pot videos, decorating videos? When do you find yourself like, because some people are like going to meal prep on a Sunday, so maybe they want a meal prep video on a Sunday, or maybe they want it on a Thursday so they can be ready for Sunday. I don't know. Communicate with me, guys, with me in the comments below, and I'm going to be reading everything. Also, if I don't respond right away, I'm working on it. If I heart your comment, I see it. I see you and I love you, but I'm really excited. I'm excited to do something a little bit different, so it's gonna be fun, you guys. I just wanted to let you guys know. Let me know what you're thinking. If you're like, girl, don't do it, just do cleaning and quit, then let me know in the comments. That's okay too. But so many of you guys have been like, yes, please add more, and I've been scared too. So I'm just gonna be testing it, see how it does, and we'll see. But okay, that was it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Got chatty at the end. It kind of was all over the place. No, it was all over the place because I am all over the place and my energy is very lacking. Like, I literally feel like I can't bend down and everything. And she's still really, really like tucked in here. And I think about 20 weeks, they kind of come out a little bit more and it'll be like more up here. So I feel kind of like cumbersome and like, I don't know. And I feel like I'm just sweating and breathing heavy like 24/7. So like, but I'm so thankful. Like, I can't even stop and say that enough. I'm so thankful, I can cry. So I'm not saying this is a derogatory thing, but I'm just saying, I'm sorry this video is all over the place because my energy is still like, so I'm working on it. I'm gonna be 16 weeks on Wednesday, so I'm super stoked about that, you guys. And that's another thing, I wanna share the ultrasounds with you guys. So, you know, I'll add the ultrasounds and stuff because I wanna share that with you guys too. So, okay, I'm gonna stop talking so much. If you haven't yet subscribed and you wanna join our journey, I would love to have you. It would be such an honor and such a privilege for you to subscribe to my channel. Hit those notification bells, click them all, and hang out with me every single week because I am so thankful for you. So I love you all so much. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Talk to me in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. 'Cause you're the one, no.